Hello, my dear comrades, my name is Deema, and welcome to the first episode of my game dev vlog.
Deema Games, this is Deema Games.
Some time ago, I was bored with enterprise software development, so I decided to build a game. And now, I'm software engineer by day, and game developer by night. As a city builder nerd, I decided on genre in no time. First, I tried to use Unity's DOTS framework. I used both URP and HDRP and had some progress with that. But due to limitation of burst compiler and my desire to make a game as performant as possible, I gave up on that. Then I tried to use Unreal, but it didn't go very well. Okay, here I have all 40 gigs of Unreal downloaded and installed. I need some assets as a starting point. This looks good. Okay, create a project. Now open in Unreal. This took some time. Let's start it and see how it looks. Wait a second. So, after realizing that I don't have an eternity, I ended up downloading Godot engine, which is open source, has a small size, and starts blazingly fast. 3D support is not perfect as for now, but it's supposed to change in future. I started with an empty project and installed a terrain plugin. Previously I wanted to be able to generate procedural terrain, but decided to give up on that, as it's pretty hard to do it properly. Also, I don't even sure my game needs it. So with the heat map terrain plugin, I started with randomly generated terrain, added some open source textures, and sculpted it with brushes. Not great, not terrible. Well, there's no point in having terrain in-game and not being able to see it from different points. So I worked on camera controller along with terrain. There's a good video tutorial how to do this in Unity, so I based my work on that. It was a pretty easy task to convert it to Godot script. But when working on that, I saw that something's missing. Delta time was not applied to movement, so when FPS was changed, the movement speed changed as well. Thankfully, the fix was very simple. The other issue was incorrect camera movement direction after rotation. For example, when you rotate the camera and press right, it moves diagonally. To change that, I applied rotation to the movement vector, which turned out to be very simple with Godot 2. Also, I wanted to have a river, so I created a plane and added a water shader from the internet. Looks somewhat like a river to me. I thought that it's a good idea to start profiling as soon as possible, so I downloaded a simple performance monitor plugin and added the ability to show it with the F4 key. Okay, this was fun. Let's take a break to pet a cat.
There's my good fella. That's my cat.
The main advantage of using Godot to me was the ability to write a part of code in C++. I set up an environment and started migrating the implementation of Poisson disk sampling I had in Unity to C++. Poisson disk sampling is a technique of randomly placing points as close to each other as possible. It's perfect to placing trees in the forest. In Unity, I used Sebastian Lagoa's version of this algorithm, adapted to run with Burst. When I tried to rewrite it to C++, I encountered a lot of errors. I suppose I need to learn C++ before using it. So I used my internet search skills and found several Poisson disk sampling libraries written in C++. But performance was the worst. As I have a big terrain size, I tried to generate like a billion points, which made my game hang. So I took another pass. I pre-generated a C++ array filled with a lot of points and added it to my native library. That way, when I need some points, I'll just need to look up an array to get them. I wanted to sort items in array, so when I get first, say, 100 points from it, I'll get points forming a small square. But my first several attempts were not successful. First, I got a triangle, and then, after changing the comparison function, a quarter of a circle. I had to take a break and get a notebook to figure that out. So first I accidentally sorted those by value of x plus y, which my sorted points form a triangle. Then I thought I need to stop being stupid and use a distance formula. I just used the sum of squares, without square root, as if x is greater than y, then the square root of x is greater than y. But this formula leads us to a circular shape. So, what needs to be done to have points ordered in square? After some thoughts, I figured out that we just need to get a max value of x and y and compare array elements by that. After a successful small square, I drew a tree map with the terrain tool. This is just an image, based on which we can plant a tree if a pixel is red. If it's black, nothing should be planted. After using models I previously bought in Unity Asset Store and adding some randomness to tree rotation and scale, I've got some nice forests. I also used a separate thread for planting trees, so it's away from the main game loop. I wanted to add some life to a forest, and Godot manual helped me with that. Adding a custom shader for tree leaves helped me simulate something similar to wind, which definitely makes trees look better on close-up. After that, I updated a terrain shader to show the grid on the ground as a preparation for a building system. I used an alpha channel of a simple texture to display a grid, and I needed a mouse position as a variable in the shader. For this, I created a separate script in a terrain wrapper to send a ray from the camera to mouse position and detect a collision with the ground. The coordinates of this collision are passed to the shader and used as the center of a grid circle. The formula for drawing it is pretty simple. Most important thing I learned is mix function, which is a synonym for lerp in Godot. Also, I created a green rectangle representing building placement. To shader, I sent a rectangle position, its size and the texture, which is just one green pixel. This texture will be more complex once I start walking on roads. It's 11 o'clock. Outside is dark, my wife is asleep. Let's make some UI. Or that's what I thought. When the project loaded, I stopped being able to load trees. Then my terrain went flat. I didn't know what went wrong. Turns out I ran out of disk space, and Godot started acting weird. I tried to recover my heat map from a normal map, but it turned up a bit ugly. So I freed some space, created a new terrain and tree map, and of course added a river. Not great, not terrible still. Luckily, I didn't spend much effort on previous version of terrain. And finally, UI time. I started with the top panel with various game stats and time controls. And oh boy, is Godot UI messed up. The weirdest thing is that only buttons have a hover state, so if I need to change a color of control on hover, I needed to write my own script, which I did, and this solution works surprisingly well. The best thing about Godot UI is how easily you can add a tooltip. Just write a text, change mouse settings, and here you go, a nice tooltip. And you can change its style in a theme. working with UI is a perfect time to start implementing internationalization. I created two locales in GetText format, registered them in project settings, and installed a plugin to be able to edit those in the editor. And now I just need to set text label to a dictionary key, and Godot replace it out of the box. After figuring out the basic of how UI controls work, I started working on a building menu. I decided to store building info in a JSON file. Sounds like not a bad idea, although I cannot edit JSON inside Godot, which is very annoying. Then I created a class which represents a building blueprint and read all JSON data into a dictionary of these objects. Having that, I was able to create a panel which contains several instances of a button scene. This was made in building panel script. Button has a different script, which shows its children on click and hides them on another click. Also, it was responsible for showing the building info panel on hover by sending a signal to it. Fixing issue with this panel was a lot of effort. At one point, I had to rework the button scene hierarchy, as I had an annoying hand mouse cursor over the empty space. Properly resizing elements was also not a trivial task. The good point is that I haven't had to store any size values inside the code. The tricky thing was adding a delay for hiding the building info panel, but I was able to solve it with some dark magic. In the end, I'm pretty happy with this panel, and UI in general. And last but not least, I committed and pushed my changes to GitLab. If I did that in the first place, flat terrain won't become a big problem to me. I have two repositories, one for the Godot project and another for C++ library. Okay, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching until this point. Hope you liked the video. I had a lot of fun with my first 40 hours in Godot. Only 9,660 hours to go, and I'll become a pro with that. If you want to support me, please leave a comment, like the video, and share it with your friends. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.